Dog is Family on BCTV is supported by Godfrey's. Welcome to Dogdom.
Hi, welcome to our show, Dog is Family. My name is Barb Emmett, and I'll be your host for this next half hour, and it's our holiday show, so thanks for joining us on this very important show that's a lot of fun as well. I'm a dog lover, certified dog lover. I have two golden retrievers. I've loved dogs for years. I'm a certified dog lover and dog mom. And I'm also the proprietor of Godfrey's Welcome to Dogdom, where we really care about the complete canine lifestyle. Our show is all about exploring how people bond with their dogs, what they do with their dogs, ways to nurture them, and ways to grow in that relationship. We like to share a lot of information. And tonight we have a really important show that's going to share information about how to help other homeless animals throughout not only our county, but many counties in Pennsylvania in general. So let me get started. You're going to see as the show's moving through some of these holiday hot products for dogs, and we will have some time at the end of the show. But for now, let's get going. I want to introduce my guests to my right. I'm very excited to have them with me. We've worked together. Joyce. Hi, Joyce.
Hi, Barb.
And this is Joyce's husband, Dave.
Hello.
Hi, you two. And who is joining us here today, you two?
Pollyanna, she's a little toy cockapoo. She's almost 5 years old. And Lovey is a Bichon. She just turned 6.
Oh, my goodness.
And both of these girls are rescue dogs. They both came out of puppy mills, and we became foster failures, and we adopted
them. You were foster failures. I don't know if people are familiar with that term, but that always means you're going to foster, and what happens?
We ended up keeping them and adopting them.
And that a failure is a very positive failure.
Yeah.
So Joyce and Dave and their two pups are personally have had a journey with dogs. First, let's talk a little bit about your journey with dogs in your lives and what they brought to your lives and how these two came to you from the foster program.
Well, we were married, it'll be 48 years here real soon.
Congratulations.
And a week after we were married, we actually got our first dog. And she was a little female beagle. Her name was Wendy Wilhide. And since then, we just counted them up, in fact, on the way here, and there have been 10 dogs in our lives, including these two.
Yeah, 10 wonderful souls.
Oh, I'll guarantee you they were.
They sure are.
We actually rescued one before, and we didn't even know it. We bought it from a pet store.
Okay.
And she had been 5 months old, and she was getting to the point where she couldn't be sold as a puppy anymore. And consequently, we got her, and the first thing we did, we took her to the vet, and the first vet said, "You need to put this dog down.
Oh, goodness.
She's got a heart murmur."
Oh, goodness.
And after going through several different vets, we finally found the right vet. And she was a Sealyham Terrier, and she had open-heart surgery within the first week after we got her, and she spent 14 years of her life with us, and it really made a difference in both of our lives, hers and ours. We learned patience. We learned unconditional love.
Yeah.
There's just so many things that these dogs teach us. And it's incredible the lives that they have lived versus what they're living now. Friends and family have told us these girls hit the lottery. Well, we feel we hit the lottery because they are so inspirational. And they do. They give you unconditional love. And you learn a lot of patience. With Lovey, the Bichon here, she was very, very damaged when we acquired her. She was that damaged that I couldn't even get close to her.
Isn't that something?
This would have been impossible 2 years ago for me to even sit beside her.
There she is.
But now, when we all four sleep together, and she sleeps.
Yes, let's talk about the bedroom.
She sleeps above my head, and every night she licks my forehead.
Kisses you goodnight.
Yep, I think her and I have finally come to an understanding, and we each know the love that we have for each other, and it's just a neat situation with them.
Well, all of these things that we're talking about today, thank you, Dave, for that history. Remind us again, it is the season, and it is the season, and the warmth and the love and the bond that develops, and what they do for us, it's very, we hear it all the time when people, we actually are rescued by the dogs that we rescue.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So that's a great summary of how many dogs have been in your life and how they've helped you. And how long have you had Lovey and how long have you had Pollyanna?
Lovey, we adopted her July of 2013. Mm. Pollyanna, we adopted her of March 2014.
Aha. Uh-huh. How did they adjust to each other?
It's just like they were meant to be with each other. And with Lovey being so damaged, Pollyanna taught her a lot of things. She never knew how to chew on a bone. She'll go and she'll look at the toys now. She doesn't pick them up. But they've learned how to run, to play in the yard. And they're just the best of buddies now.
It's so funny with Polly. She'll actually grab Lovey by the ear and drag her around the backyard. And Lovey just
Lovey
follows.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, let's get into how you became volunteers for helping other homeless dogs. When did that take a turn, and how did that happen?
Well, that actually happened, I guess, in June of 2013. We had lost our Schnauzer. And a friend of ours, after 6 weeks, 8 weeks, the silence in your home is deafening. It's just, there's no clang of the licenses, there's no pitter-patter, you know, there's nothing. And a friend of ours suggested that we foster. Well, we looked around and Joyce found Lovey, and we put in an application. Joyce went to visit, and she came back and she says, "Dave, I found a dog that I really want you to go look at." Well, I went, and she was in a large kennel area. And Joyce said, "You just go in and sit down and see if she'll come to you." Well, my gosh, she was so damaged, I couldn't even get close to her. And I was somewhat reluctant, but again, Joyce had the perception to know that this dog needed help and that we were the ones to do it. And consequently, we took her home, I guess, within the week. Mm-hmm. And it was really trying when we first started with her.
It's actually harder than raising and training a brand new puppy.
Oh, it
a
is.
A very damaged dog like mm-hmm. Lovey was. Mm-hmm. It takes a lot of love and patience, a ton of patience. And we even worked with a trainer, certified trainer in Ephrata, to help us get through this.
Well, now you're wearing, our viewers are going to be seeing, you're wearing some shirts, and I'm very excited to bring information to our viewers about Leo's Helping Paws. And both of you are part of that and volunteers for that organization. Can you tell us what the organization's all about?
Well, our actual mission statement, our mission statement is to provide financial assistance to pet rescues that need to have animals taken to vets to have certain procedures done to make them whole and happy and healthy. And that's our financial obligation to Leo's. In addition to that, we're let's call it a warehouse for supplies. One thing about Leo's, and we talk about pet rescues, Leo's does not physically go rescue the dogs. We are there to support financially and through supplies the rescues that do have the dogs. There's so many of them out there. They're all financially strapped. They take dogs unconditional, and they need help. And that's what we do. We are fortunate in that we're good fundraisers. And when I say fundraisers, we are always having an opportunity for the general public to contribute and donate through ticket sales, through raffles, bingo, you name it, we do it to raise funds. And which takes me to how successful we've been. Leo's has only been in operation less than 18 months right now. And prior to that, we all had experiences with other groups and came together to form Leo's to complete this statement, the mission statement. And in doing so, we have given out over $65,000 worth of grants since our existence less than 18 months ago. It's so easy. If you're a rescue and go to Leo's website, there's a form on there. You click on the form. It's the grant application. You fill out the grant application. You hit the button. You send it back. And that starts the ball rolling. There may be certain questions that would need to be asked, you know, to be completed and back and forth a little. But typically, it's pretty clear as to what we're doing. And we support these organizations that are totally volunteer. And I might also add that Leo's is totally volunteer as well. We are a 501c3 nonprofit registered organization, and just out to raise funds to help the dogs and do whatever we can to support them.
Well, I thank you, Dave, for that overview, because that's really what I see. A lot of the groups that are rescue groups that use the foster mm-hmm. system, whether they're in their homes or they're volunteers, they don't have a facility, as you said. They need money, they are legitimate, and they're doing great work, and they don't have a permanent facility. I know mm-hmm. groups like Zoe's House, different, mostly Mutts, all kinds, and I think you'll talk about that, but what impressed mm-hmm. me the most was that you folks put together a process very quickly for these rescue groups to contact you, to have a good mm-hmm. group reviewing the grant process, to be able to release the funds without a whole lot of red tape, I guess, right? Yes. And get that money working for these mm-hmm. All these animals that need homes. And that has been what's really impressed me about the organization and what you're doing. You've told us when it was funded. You do a lot of fundraisers. Tell us some stories, maybe about some specifics of some dogs and some rescue groups you folks have helped. Can you share?
Well, Ava, which is a pit bull.
Is that a photo they might be able to show that we turned over Ava? Did we turn that photo over mm-hmm. to the...
Yes,
yeah,
we
gave them that.
There's Ava.
I got a phone call, I think a couple weeks mm-hmm. ago, from a lady I didn't even know, and it was through your help, Barb, that she was able to get to us, and with her information, we've been able to get funding through a grant, through the Polished Pit Bull organization, that we've been able to get Ava the help that she needs. And even though it's not totally finished, we're not giving up by one grant saying this is all you're going to get. We're going to make sure and follow this through with Ava to make sure that she gets the help that she needs.
The veterinary care, follow that. You help all the way through.
And
we do.
Just to take Ava one step farther, we found out that she's going to be on a special dog food, mm-hmm. which we did not have in our food bank and really didn't know where to obtain. So we found it online, and we bought it online, and it's being shipped
Wonderful.
To Ava's home.
Wonderful.
To help.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Any other stories?
Clementine is another one.
Is there a photo of Clementine we could share?
Yep.
I don't know her
there
whole
she is.
Story.
Is that her?
That's her.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, she's a Rottweiler. There is some fundraising being done to help her with medical needs as well. There's an event up at Quentin, a Santa Paws event. They're doing fundraising for that. We have flyers at the Pancake Farm to tell Clementine's story, what the medical needs are to help her as well.
It sounds like the Pancake Farm is the hub for a lot of what goes on with Leo's Helping Paws. Can you tell us how that came to be?
Well,
or why?
There's two ladies that own the Pancake Farm, Kathy Steyer and Beth Buchter. Both very much animal lovers, dog lovers, and they rescued a couple of different
corgis.
Corgis, mm-hmm. And They're the hub. They're the cement that put the thing together.
Okay.
And we used the basement of their rescue as a warehouse.
Okay.
And again, we stock a lot of different supplies. And I have a listing of those that I'll run down if you like. But the food, and one other thing I need to interject, we continue to talk about the dogs, but we also do cat supplies and
okay.
cat food and cat
yes.
toys
yes.
and things like that as well. We're just not zeroed in on dogs. They are our primary function, but equally as important is the cat side.
Mm-hmm.
So we're also soliciting food and supplies for cats as well. But anyway, to get back to the girls, they're the people that initiated Leo's.
Excellent.
And in fact, Leo is on the shirts, and this is actually their dog.
Okay.
Okay, with one ear up, one ear down. That's Leo's trademark. He gets to a couple of events a year. But we have gathered, amassed a group of volunteers. And when I say amassed a group, we're about 25 strong.
Wow.
So with those 25 people, we have come a long way and have done a whole lot in this 18 months since the
you
inception.
You sure have.
And we're very proud of that.
You should be very proud
very
of that.
Proud.
Yeah. When we have these here, can you talk about the organizations maybe in general that have been helped by these dogs or these dogs? Is there anybody you wanted to share anything with about
Well, I can
these,
give you
Dave?
A rundown of some of them. Our bylaws and our mission statement includes dogs, or I should say the territory, Pennsylvania and neighboring states. One thing that we've actually done, we have gone to New York, we've gone to New Jersey to deliver supplies.
We've had rescues come as far away as North Carolina.
My goodness.
And we have been able to help them with some supplies also, because there is such a need for it.
So your reach is growing
it
more
is.
And more.
It
They're showing, the camera is showing, thank you very much, keep spanning some of these dogs that have been helped.
Just to give you an idea, Columbia, Elizabethtown, Quentin, Lewistown, North Wales, Burnham, Columbia, Patterson, Hockessin, Delaware, Limerick, Pennsylvania, New Oxford, Pennsylvania, Edgewater, New Jersey, Danville, West Virginia. Again, it's not limited. It's amazing where all we've been.
You
so
have
far.
Been. And it is an organization must approach you. It wouldn't be anybody out there. It would be going through a particular rescue organization coming to you.
That's correct.
Correct.
That's
right?
Correct.
We want to be
yep.
very clear
yep.
about
yep.
that.
Right.
That it is through a rescue yes. organization, yes. independent.
So okay. And it's so difficult to reject an individual.
Oh.
And we've actually done special benefit type raffles for that type of a situation.
Okay. So you even try to include things outside the grants or the supplies.
Right.
But again, that is more so through the girls at the pancake farm than it is through Leo's, although it's all connected.
Okay.
You know? So there are, I don't want to say exceptions, but there's certain situations that we run into that we just feel
imagine.
Compelled that we need to help these people
yeah.
and the
I
dogs.
I can imagine. You know, some of the other things I think we should touch on, how about plans going forward? You're growing at a rapid rate. What do you see coming along?
Well, we have...
There's a lot going on
it.
And you're growing. We're sharing what you're doing.
We have a Christmas raffle going right now for Clementine, which we talked about.
Uh-huh.
We're selling at the pancake farm, we're selling dog toys, dog treats, Christmas hats, candies, holiday items, people side of it, candles.
Jewelry.
You just had an art auction recently.
Yeah, we did.
Very
that
successful.
Was
other.
And we're already planning for the next one.
That's
We've got to get
excellent.
A bigger facility.
How do you let the world know what you're doing? And how do you build your volunteer base? How's that happening?
Word of mouth.
Good.
People just finding us, hearing a little bit about us, and then that raises the question, what are these people all about? And a cute story. We were down at the pancake farm the other week. And one of the lady servers down there, she said, Dave, is that your car out there with that dog in? I said, no, it's not. I said, our girls are home today. And she said, well, the couple in the corner saw a dog and wondered. So I went over and started talking to them. Well, before you know it, there was another girl in there that she had two dogs that she was looking to try to adopt or find a place for them. And we got these people together. And within a week, the people that had no dogs now had two dogs. Wow. The girl that was looking for the homes, you know, found an excellent home. And just an absolutely wonderful situation for these dogs.
And in the end, we gained two more volunteers.
Excellent. You do good work and you get more people and the word's out there. You get it those involved because they want to help others as well.
The website, the Facebook page, all of those are ways to identify with Leo's and to find out what we're doing.
I think we turned in your web address and your email, maybe if you have that back there, that we can show the folks that are watching how to contact Leo's Helping Paws and their Facebook page.
And if you're in Ephrata, you come by the Pancake Farm on 272. There's a big billboard right out in front of the Pancake Farm that has Leo's Helping Paws on it.
And there it is. There's the website. Mm-hmm. There's the address. Yep. And there is a Facebook page as well that folks can go to. So I think you've done an excellent job. The Lovey and Pollyanna are just so thrilled with what's going on here. I mean, they love being the ambassadors for Leo's Helping Paws. And they're wearing their holiday attire. We're so happy that they've joined us with that. Is there anything else you'd like to finish with us before we move on to some holiday hot products?
I don't think so.
Well, when you said ambassadors, they truly are.
They are.
No matter where we go, people just say, can we please pet them? Can we take pictures? And of course, we never never decline the options there, but they are. They're so good. And you have to socialize these dogs. That's what they're lacking. When you take a crated puppy mill dog and try to change them around, and it's a whole psychological thing, more so, I think, than the physical thing. Mm-hmm. You really have to work with them. But we've come a long way, and they are definitely ambassadors.
Well, they certainly look content here in the studio. They can come back anytime. How about that?
Thank
they might have more
so
stories
much.
To tell.
I think so.
So many dogs. Is there a count of how many you've helped? Do you have a total?
Somewhere around 60, between 50 and 60. And one other thing, we submitted that card with all the stockings on it.
Oh, let's
if you
show
go
that.
To the if you go to the pancake farm.
Great idea. Yeah.
Right inside the door. There is a stocking hung for every dog that we have helped so far.
It's very impressive.
And that's really neat. And just the other day, Joyce and I went and we bought 50 more stockings for the future.
That's
so
excellent.
We're really excited about adding more. And Kathy said the other day, she said, I'd like to ring this whole place in these stockings.
And you will.
And
I think you have a great
will.
Video on your Facebook page of all the
we
dogs
do.
You've helped, which I think
we
tells
do.
A story right there.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So thank you both, for all four of you, for coming on the show today. And I think you might want to watch some of the things that are going on with our holiday tips as well.
I think so.
So there might be some things you like over here, but I think we're pretty comfortable. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you.
Well, we'll transition into holiday hot products for dogs and dogdom. Every year, there's always a new hot line of things that are going on. And what's really going on in the pet industry right now are electronic toys. Tech has gone to the dogs. One of the new products that is getting a very good review on Amazon.com is called the Petsy. And if you can close in on this a little bit, you're seeing a plastic dispenser, and you're wondering, what in the world is this? This is actually a camera that can do a wide angle view of a room. This lid opens with treats. Now, I already have it filled with treats. So that sounds like something that might be a good thing for dogs. Let's see what this can do. The Petsy has been designed as an app on your phone. So if you have a phone, you can easily connect And there's very easy instructions from all the reviews on Amazon. People are thrilled with this. Now, every now and then, there's a bad unit. But all you have to do is start your application once you've done the installation. You can call your dog. There's a little sound that happens when you've hooked onto your app. Next thing you know, your dogs hear this sound, tinkle, tinkle, tinkle. And I didn't want to activate it today because I didn't want to upset these two. They're too happy. So anyway, a sound comes on through your cell phone. You hit a button on your cell phone. You can talk to your dog or cats. It's been very successful with dogs and cats. Talk to them. They come over to the unit. On your app, you have a button to hit for the treat. There's just a little bone. You hit that, hold it down. Two or three treats come out. And your dog is, you don't want to overfeed, of course, but is a separation anxiety issues or dogs that get lonely or the people are needing to see their dogs or cats while they're at work on a long day. It's becoming more and more that you're going to be seeing so many more tech products for dogs. We had talked about one of the other voice products, which I was testing with my dog Jackson, which talks about their heart rate, their heartbeat, all their health monitors. I can look at that at any time. So tech is really big in the pet world now as well. So you can get some kind of comfort level when you're away that things are happening. Now they've given us, for this show, they've actually given us a thing to announce here on this show that there is a special if you're interested and you check it out. We get nothing from this. It's nothing to do with anything other than if you're interested in this product, you can actually, they only sell it through Amazon.com, but you can actually go on there and there is a $50 discount for our Dog is Family viewers. And they're offering that through the end of December. So it is through Amazon.com. You need the code DIF2015. That would be your promotion code on Petzi.com, P-E-T-Z-I.com. Again, nothing comes back here. This is nothing to do with me. It has everything to do with if you think this is a fun product for you or your grand dog or someone else who needs a little help at home with their dog to stay a little more involved. Check it out. And you can have a promo code through December 31st. Now, some of the other things here, of course, new puppies are coming in. And we have some items if you're trying to buy for a new puppy in your family. The Chili Dog is a wonderful product to look into for puppies. You put cold water on that, you freeze that, and they can chew. It's very gentle on their gums. Refreeze it. Very nice beginning. Toy or product if you're buying for a new puppy in the home. This is a snuggle pup. It's called Snuggle Pup with a Little Heartbeat. For new puppies, many times when they're trying to relax and they miss their mother's heartbeat, mother puppy, this is a great product for new puppies. And a Pupsicle, which is a frozen product, which put water in that, freeze it. It's very good for the teething and the gums. All the time we're seeing new products. Then we have very nice stuffed toys that are durable, a book for that dog lover, dog mom, dog dad in the world. It is a natural dog book, which you know we talk all about natural things here on Godfrey's. We want the most purest products. West Paw is a brand that makes these nice mats out of recycled water bottles, so they're doing something good for the environment. Always popular on the list is the Hideaways. And of course, puzzle toys. We have many of those on the market to keep the dogs working with you and stimulated. A Kong, hard Kong with treats. Things to do to stimulate the mind of your dogs. Well, that's about the wrap up. I have been thrilled to be here. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Happy holidays to all our viewers, to all the pups out there watching. And we hope that you'll come back and see us in January with the next show, Dog is Family. Have a great holiday. Thank you.
Dog is Family on BCTV is supported by Godfrey's. Welcome to Dogdom.